Hello everyone. Today, we'll get to know how to use the zoom in pan feature to zoom in and zoom out a specific part of the content. In general, you use a zoom in pan object to zoom in, then use another one to zoom out. To insert a zoom in pan object, open the Annotations tab and click Zoom in Pan. This is the zoom in pan object that you can drag and place anywhere on the canvas. If you want to have a more precise position of the effect on the slide, change the value from this section of the Properties pane. Here are the positions of the zoom rectangle from the left and top side of the slide. This box is to change the zoom area size. The bigger value you set, the smaller zoom region you make. Alternatively, you can hover the mouse over one of the four green handles until the mouse turns into a two-headed arrow and drag the handle to change the zoom scale. Now, take a look at the object time bar in the timeline pane. The zoom effect will start to zoom in at the start point of the object and end at the green diamond. The light blue area inside the object time bar indicates the effect timing. To change the start time, drag the object time bar to the left or right. Or, you can change the value in the start time box. Besides, this box is to change the effect duration. By default, the duration of the zoom and pan effect is 1 second. You can change it to any other values. However, it shouldn't be too short or too long. 1 to 3 seconds are good to go, since a smooth and unhurried effect is better for viewers to follow. You can also drag the green diamond or the start point of the time bar to the left or right to change the effect timing. Let's preview the effect. When the presentation is playing, you can let it zoom in different parts of the screen continuously. To do that, insert the second zoom in pan object in the slide and place it where you want to zoom in next. Then, change its start time, duration, and scale as explained before. When the slide is displayed, you will see the effect like watching a camera show the entire screen, then zoom in and pan simultaneously sideways to a smaller part. Next, the camera will gradually move to the other part of the screen. The zoom and pan object has a one-way effect. When it ends, it does not restore the zoom back to normal. This means the project will keep displaying while zooming at a small part of the slide. You have to insert another zoom and pan object to zoom back to normal view. To do that, select the timestamp that you want to zoom back, then insert a zoom and pan object. Resize the zoom rectangle to cover the entire slide. Alternatively, you can enter 100 in the zoom scale box. The presentation will start to go back to the normal view when it reaches this zoom and pan object. To delete the zoom and pan effect, just select the object and press the delete key on your keyboard. That's all about using Zoom and Pan in Active Presenter 7. Thank you for watching.